television. I love Jan and Paul on Channel 40, and I love Benny Hinn. I love when he says, everybody, there's gonna be some healing tonight. We watch these evangelical shows, and, you know, they're saying, just send in some money now, or, you know, that this number is on your screen. And I would say, Alan, let's send in the 50 bucks now. I mean, you know, then we just, you know, you're safe for the afterlife. You know, you're done.
If you had your own religion, let's say it's Ullmanism, what would some of the commandments be?
Thou shalt always be funny.
College, we used to sit around and have these heavy discussions on religion. And one night, somebody said, do you believe in God? And someone else responded, I believe in a God. And then I thought about it and really strained that concept through my spiritual self. And only then did I realize that the difference between believing in God and a God is the A.
I told you, people! I'm already familiar with your Jehovah, and I'm not interested. Jeez, when did the Jehovah's Witnesses turn Mexican? That religion's going downhill, if you ask me. I was never a religious person. My family don't believe in that stuff, probably because they were all going to hell. Yeah, the closest thing I ever got to a religious experience was when I was working on a little Bible pic starring Mr. Max von Sydow as Jesus. It was called The Greatest Story Ever Told. That's a matter of opinion, yeah. And that was the first picture I ever got fired off of by Mr. George Stevens, thank you very much. Apparently, some of the wine was missing from the Last Supper scene, and that bitch, Angela Lansbury, pointed the finger at me. If you ask me, she was just protecting Van Heflin. Anywho, I was real happy when they canceled her TV show. Hey!
My favorite passage in the Bible is Isaiah 34:14, because that's where Lilith is first mentioned. She was, according to Jewish folklore, a she-devil who paid no attention to Adam, ran wild, and killed infants. Well, Adam got fed up with her, and I'm sure she wasn't too excited about him. Any guy who gives his rib away is a pussy! So they separated. First marriage on Earth goes belly up. Now, if she had a decent lawyer like myself, she would have gotten the Garden of Eden and the mineral rights. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Midge Dexter gets the birdie. That'll do nicely.
Wow.
Oh, honey. Oh.
That's all the kiss I get from you?
Kiss it on.
Let's do it again. Honey, I'm so glad you're here. You made me do that.
Congratulations, Midge, on a great round.
Thank you very much.
Chris, come on in here.
Is this my Bethany wasting one of the Lord's sunniest days?
Now, Chris, I understand that you're going to be on home turf this week.
Well, yeah, that's right. I left quite a while ago, but I want to say hi, Mom and Dad, and, of course, Aunt Birdie in Evanville. Hi, Mitch.
Oh. Hi.
She had a great round, right?
She did.
Mama, wasn't that Cousin Chris saying
wonderful,
hi to you?
Cousin Chris is dead.
But, Mama, I saw her.
When Mama tells you someone is dead, they're dead. Now, Bethany, honey, run outside and work on your ark.
Yes, Mama.
Go on.
Good afternoon, Straightways.
Hello, Sandy. Is that you?
Why, Sister B. I knew you were about to call. You were in physical pain about 2 a.m. last night, weren't you, Sister?
Oh, the Lord has blessed us with our twin telepathy. You're right. I was in pain. We had breaded oysters for dinner, and it made Bob Sr. want to go forth and multiply real bad.
But that's not all that's troubling you now, is it, B?
Oh, Sandy, you're right again. I just saw our niece Christine on the TV with that Antichrist girlfriend of hers. They were at the Pine Tops Country Club. Oh, why did they ever let women into that place?
Can't you see, B? The Lord has brought his prodigal lamb close to her flock so that a good shepherd like yourself can catch her, drug her, tie her up, and deliver her to straightways.
Oh, Sandy, you're right. I'm bringing her in for the cure.
Hallelujah. Matthew, we have a new soul to straighten.
I'll put her in the Reagan wings, sir.
Matthew.
Yes, sir.
Wrists.
I'm sorry, sir. Sometimes the old ways come back to torment me.
To your knees, boy! Homo be gone. Homo be gone!
I'm straight. I am straight.
And it's another beautiful day here at Pine Tops Country Club. Out early and have made a good start against par. Here's Dexter about to tee off on 18. And she certainly got a hold of that one. What a lovely drive, right to the heart of the fairway. She's ideally placed to reach the green in two, giving her a chance of an eagle here on 18. Mitch Dexter, currently our tournament leader at 10 under par. And this puts her in an ideal position to win this, her third tournament of the year, going into tomorrow's final round.
Ah, a birdie. Hi there, famous niece. I saw you on the TV, and I figured it was time to bury the hatchet. Oh, Aunt Bertie. Oh, I'm so happy. I can't believe I'm talking to you again after you spat in my face and shaved my head.
That's all water under the bridge now, sweetheart.
I would love for you to meet Mitch. Let me go and get her, okay?
No!
Oh, no, don't go and do that.
We don't want to take her mind off her balls now, do we?
How about you and your girlfriend coming over for dinner tonight?
Now, what exactly is it that you daughters of lesbos like to eat?
Oh, anything you want to make us would be just great.
Oh, then it's settled.
Let me give you my new address. It's on Dan Quayle Drive. I'll leave your name with the mercenary on the gate.
Gotcha!
Devil's so strong. Be still, girl. Go for a ride, baby.
Why, Bertie Gutson, what are you doing with your arms around that homo?
Shh, Lyle. You're witnessing an intervention on behalf of the Lord. This is my niece, Christine. Now quit gawking and help me get her in the car. Come on.
Bless you, Bertie. Oh. So, where are you taking her?
I'm taking her to my brother Sandy's compound to be sexually decontaminated.
Mm-hmm. You want somebody's head on her so she don't get away?
No, that won't be necessary, Lyle. Now, you go back and do the Lord's work. Thank you. God bless.
Where's Chris? Oh, I guess she went behind a bush to take a pee.
Yeah.
Wicked, wicked girl, Christine. If you only knew the shame, suffering, humiliation, and degradation you rained upon this family when you ran off with that she-he woman. I should have known you had the devil lurking in your soul the way you latched onto your mother's breast. We had to practically throw rocks at you to get your little gums to part.
Sandy, I'm here. Can somebody help me with my lesbian?
Look, you have to understand, Detective. It's not like her to run off like that. I found her blanket and her purse on the dogleg of the 12th hole. This whole thing is very strange.
Now, you people aren't particularly loyal to each other now, are you?
What? Excuse me? What are you saying?
It just sounds to me like, you know, she ran off with another one of your kind. There's lots of dykes on spikes around these parts right now.
You asshole! A pig gun.
Let me out! What the hell is going on?
Please! There's no cursing at Straightways.
Straightways? That's a homosexual deprogramming center. I saw a documentary about it on HBO.
Do not speak of the home bestiality organization in God's home.
Oh my God.
Sit down. You're free from your impulses here, Miss Warner. 6 months ago, I was living in San Francisco with a pet dachshund and a guy named Brett, and all three of us wore studded collars. Now look at me. Before, I would have told this story with a lot of extravagant hand gestures. Now I do it in a composed and masculine manner. I have a degree in advanced Bible studies, and I just love women.
You and me both.
Well, you'll change your mind after your electro purification.
What? Homo be gone. Homo be gone. Homo be gone. Homo be gone.
I know it hurts, but he's working on a patch.
Hey, I want a word with you.
Oh, you get away from me, sinner. I'm late for church.
Listen, you miserable little bigot. You know what happened to my girlfriend. You were near her when she disappeared.
Oh, get out of my way, faggot.
I'm not a faggot. I'm a lesbian.
Having some trouble here, Midge?
Sure am, girls.
Why, look who it is, girls. It's Poster Boy.
No, no, go on. Now, get away from me, please.
Now,
no,
where
no,
is
no.
she? You I tell me where she is. Had... You have cohorts. Oh, you're in big Holy trouble now, God. Aren't you? You know where she is.
Put your hands together in prayer. Oh, Lord. We thank you for curing your children of their illness. We want to thank you for delivering Christine to us safely.
Thank you.
We want to thank you for clearing Glenn's colon of marsupials.
Thank you.
Everybody, let's sing our first hymn and raise our voices to the rafters. Really let Jesus hear you. Let Jesus hear you.
Christian soldiers marching as to war.
Okay, girls, wait here. I'm gonna try to do this peacefully. Peace. Chris, thank God I found you. Come on, honey, let's go. The car's right outside. Come on. Uncle Sandy, homo alert! Homo alert!
Say it!
Chris, what
Bring her
done?
Unto me.
What have they done to you?
Chris, what is it?
What? Let go! Chris, stop them! Oh, Lord!
Look who has been delivered to us today, Jimmy! One of the biggest homosexual sinners in the country!
Homo bigoton!
You homo
bigoton! Get away! Get away! Chris, I love you. I'll always love you. What we are and what we feel isn't wrong, and the real God knows that.
You heathen. Oh,
Mitch, I love you too.
Chris. Oh,
I'm gonna wait. What's going on? Come back. What's going on? Great Hulk.
Leave them alone, you big bully!
Matthew, come with us. You'll be home for Halloween.
Halloween?
Oh,
Lord.
Mama, you all right?
Oh, I think it's that time of the month again when the state troopers get a hold of your Uncle Sandy. Oh!
Oh, how wonderful for the Secretary of State, Madeleine Albright, to discover she's Jewish. So now she can stop dressing so schlumpy. And Madeleine, you know the hair? It's gotta be bigger. Oh, and I wanna do your nails. When you point at those grubby little Arab leaders, I want you to nick their nostrils with a well-shaped acrylic tip. Now, but mind you gotta maintain acrylic. And if you snap down to a nail bed in Angola, oh, Christ. And I expect you're having trouble with your country club. Yeah, you gotta switch. And there's no good temple or deli in Washington. Oh, Maddie, you gotta call me. Will Kibbutz.
Excuse me.
Yes.
I don't mean to disturb you, Miss Granger, but I am such a big fan of yours.
I don't know why I bother with this disguise.
Oh, look how beautiful you are in person.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Meade. I'm a writer.
Oh, I love writers. You know, I'm one of the actresses that appreciates the written word. I feel that it gives me things to say that otherwise I wouldn't be able to think of myself. So. Would you like to join me for a rumba frappuccino?
I'd adore it.
Stone, another rumba frappuccino.
I can't believe I'm actually meeting you. I used to watch VIP Lounge in high school. I never missed an episode. Yeah. I can still quote whole pages of dialogue.
You're very kind.
So are you.
Oh.
Would you do me a favor?
Yes.
Would you say my favorite line? It was the one you said to Barbara Stanwyck when she played Beverly Cassel. Thank you.
Thank you.
Head of airport security. You know, I've got a lounge full of VIPs.
And it's my job to make sure that they get on those planes happy, damn it. Now, Miss Cassel, if you'd excuse me, I've got a tray full of mini muffins that should have been freshened
10 minutes ago.
Oh, look at me, I'm acting it out.
I've got goosebumps. I think I'm gonna cry.
No.
Oh, you know, that show inspired me to become a writer.
Really? Would I be familiar with any of your work, Jonathan?
Well, I've written quite a few plays.
Oh, I love plays. They're so theatrical. Mm-hmm.
But what I'm really trying to do is break into TV.
That's where the real money is, I'm afraid.
You know, I've written a pilot that you would be wonderful for. Oh, but I bet you've got commitments all over the place.
No, well, yes and no. Why don't you tell me about your script, Jonathan?
Well,
yes.
The lead character is named Angela. Mm-hmm. She's a glamorous woman in her early 40s, or late 30s.
Oh, me like. Go on.
And in the pilot, she visits a church, and while she's kneeling there, God comes to her and tells her he wants to make her an angel. Angela.
Oh, and that must surprise her.
Yes, oh, what can she do? She can't say no to God.
No, because that would make her an unsympathetic lead character.
So she does what he asks her to do.
Yeah.
She becomes a cruise director for a ship called the Heavenly Peace. And every week, different celebrity guest stars come on, and she shows them the error of their ways and leads them back to the Lord.
Oh, Jonathan, I just got a chill.
Really?
You know, I'd love my manager, Candy Casino, to hear about this. I think that we should take this into the networks.
I'm gonna squeal! Can I have a hug?
Oh, of course, darling. Of course, shall we sit or shall we stand? Oh, Candy, I am this Angela Sinclair character. It's as if God wrote it for me through wonderful, wonderful Jonathan.
Oh. It's not bad, kid. Not bad at all. But I don't think the networks are going to give a TV show to some guy who wrote a one-act play that was performed above an auto body shop on Lancashire Boulevard.
Even with a big star like Linda attached?
Well, maybe.
He's right, Candy. You know, they did a survey in this month's Advocate, and I was voted number 3 star that gay males would most like to see return to a weekly TV series. The first two were the Olsen twins, naturally.
Them.
I voted online in that survey.
Oh, my goodness. You're gay?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Candy, please, please promise me you'll get us a meeting at the network.
All right, sweetie, all right.
Oh.
I'll call in some favors.
Group hug.
Group hug. Come back for group hug.
Come on. Everybody.
Hello, God. It's me, Linda Granger. Long time no see, huh? I expect you remember me as Linda Wardkowski. Look, I'm lighting a candle for you. Oh, I shouldn't have stayed away from your house for so long. I'd forgotten how flattering the lighting was in here. As you probably know, Lord, I'm researching a role I'm working on, and much like my character, Angela, I need to know if you still love me, God. Do you?
Yes, Miss Granger.
Oh, God, please call me Linda.
Linda?
Oh!
I'm sorry. Oh, of course, God still loves you.
Oh, Father, I'm so sorry. I thought God was speaking to me.
Oh, but he is. He speaks to all of us if only we'd listen.
Even somebody like me. I turned my back on him a long, long time ago.
But God never turned his back on you. Excuse me. It's like on that VIP lounge.
Yes?
Where you had to give the Heimlich maneuver to Jack Carter, even though he'd been unkind to you earlier in the episode. Oh, what was that, the line you said to Karen Valentine?
This man may have treated me badly this morning,
but he's still a VIP, and I can't let him die, damn it! Oh.
Incidentally, it was Valerie Bertinelli.
Oh, no.
Well, it doesn't matter. Oh, I didn't realize a priest watched VIP Lounge.
Oh, please. Time stood still in the rectory when that show was on.
Oh.
Don't you see, Linda? You're a VIP in God's lounge. And no matter how much you've forgotten him or mistreated him, you're always going to be a VIP. And he's always going to take care of you. Just like you took care of Jack Carter.
Oh, Father, I just got a chill. I feel like I've found my real family again.
I think God just got a chill, too.
Oh.
Maybe, oh, I'm sorry. Would you like to sing at our folk mass one of these Sundays?
Oh, Sunday. Yes. Does it have to be Sunday? Because Saturday is so much better for me.
Oh.
Heavenly peace. Think love boat / touched by an angel. And Linda plays cruise ship worker.
But she's really an angel who helps celebrity guests find God.
Celebrities being, and I have a guarantee from Ed Begley, Marky Post, Lady Kazan.
Linda, excuse me. I don't mean to interrupt you, but I got to stop you right there. We already have a project that sounds very similar to this called God on Board. Now, we have a commitment from Cher and Liza Minnelli to play the angels. And Jason Alexander is going to be the bartender, Morty, if Seinfeld doesn't run for another season. So,
well, it sounds wonderful. I think we're in the wrong room.
I gave you the gist of the show on the phone, Jay. If you would have mentioned that it was already in development, we could have been at one of 20 other meetings already. Linda, let's go, honey. We'll do it UPN right now. Come on, babe.
We are?
Oh, sure. Of course. They're desperate for a white show.
May the best God boat win. Come on.
I love Cher, and I'm quite fond of Liza. Do you think there's any way I could write for your show?
Well, you certainly have the sensibility that we're looking for.
You believe that, Judas?
Who represents you?
I do. Let's go, honey.
Call you later, Linda. We're still going to go see Pillow Talk at the museum, right?
Of course, Jonathan. Rock was a friend.
It was a goddamn outrage. I'm sorry I put you through that, Linda.
Do we really have a meeting at UPN?
No, but we will have a very visible lunch in the commissary.
Oh.
Listen, I hope you don't mind me representing that gay bastard. But after what happened, I figure one of us should make some money out of this deal, huh?
Yeah, I don't mind at all, Candy. And besides, I have a bigger deal than any network could ever offer me. I have a firm commitment from God.
Oh, thank you.
It's the voice of hope. It's the voice of peace. It's the voice of every man.
Religious person, but I was very impressed with the evangelical healer, Mr. Benny Hinn. Yes. So when I saw in the Toluca that he was appearing at the Nordhoff Open Air Stadium for the Arts, I decided to take Mother along in search of a miracle. Sadly, we never got closer than parking lot D40 Green. There were so many people. But I sat my mother on the pavement and we listened to the service over the loudspeakers, yes. A bit of a miracle did occur, however, when Mother took her first steps in 40 years when we were threatened by a Chicano gang member. God works in mysterious ways, especially in the valley.
His Holiness the Pope, Your Royal Highness.
Ah, I'm on the other team. Though, of course, if we delve far enough back into history, we used to be on the same side. Henry VIII started his own church when one of your predecessors wouldn't grant him a divorce. You're still not too keen on it, are you? Most of your flock go along with it, along with the ban on rubber johnnies. They must be petrified that if they sin, they won't get into heaven. Personally, heaven holds very little appeal. After living as a royal here on earth, heaven's going to be a tremendous disappointment. Goodbye.
Trace.
Good night, Trace.